Blue Origin just delayed. New Glenn's maiden launch. What is happening? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Blue Origin has now announced that it will target the first ever launch of its orbital-class New Glenn rocket for the night of January 9th to 10th, 2025. This significant milestone will occur at Launch Complex 36 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida, with the launch window opening at 1 a.m. ET on Friday, which translates to 10 p.m. PT on Thursday. Blue Origin has planned to stream the countdown live on blueorigin.com, starting roughly an hour before the scheduled liftoff, inviting the public to witness this historic event. The New Glenn rocket, named in honor of astronaut John Glenn, will carry the Blue Ring Pathfinder on its maiden voyage. This payload is crucial as it will test the communications, power, and control systems intended for Blue Origin's Blue Ring multi-use space platform. This test flight is not just a demonstration of Blue Origin's capabilities, but also part of a broader initiative supported by the Pentagon's Defense Innovation Unit for prototyping orbital logistics solutions. The development of New Glenn has been a long-term project for Blue Origin, spanning over a decade. This launch represents a critical step, not just in showcasing the rocket's capabilities, but also in validating years of engineering and testing. Jarrett Jones, the senior vice president for the New Glenn program, emphasized the importance of this launch, stating, "This is our first flight, and we've prepared rigorously for it. But no amount of ground testing or mission simulations are a replacement for flying this rocket. It's time to fly. No matter what happens, we'll learn, refine, and apply that knowledge to our next launch." New Glenn is an impressive piece of engineering, standing at over 320 feet, 98 meters tall, with a 7-meter, 23-foot-wide payload fairing. This fairing offers twice the volume of standard 5-meter fairings used by other rockets, providing significant advantages for payload configuration. While SpaceX's Falcon 9 uses a slightly smaller 5.2-meter fairing, and its Starship boasts a 9-meter one, New Glenn's design aims at a niche in the market where size and volume are critical. The rocket's first stage is equipped with 7 BE-4 engines, which utilize liquefied natural gas, a cleaner and potentially more economical fuel choice compared to traditional rocket fuels. These engines will generate a maximum thrust of about 3.8 million pounds at liftoff, roughly half of what the Saturn V moon rockets produced during the Apollo missions. The second stage employs 2 hydrogen-fueled BE-3U engines, which are designed for efficiency in the vacuum of space. After the rocket stage is separate, an ambitious plan follows where the first stage booster aims to execute a controlled descent to land on a barge named Jacqueline in tribute to Bezos's mother, located hundreds of miles into the Atlantic Ocean. This recovery operation, if successful, would mark Blue Origin's entry into the reusable rocket club, a feat that has significantly reduced launch costs for competitors like SpaceX. Blue Origin CEO Dave Limp expressed both the challenge and the optimism of the endeavor, mentioning on X, "No one has landed a reusable booster on the first try. Yet we're going for it, and humbly submit having good confidence in landing it." The successful execution of this mission would not only counter criticisms regarding Blue Origin's long gestation period without an orbital launch, but also position Blue Origin more competitively against SpaceX, which has dominated the market since its inception. Blue Origin has lined up several New Glenn vehicles in production at its Florida factory, with a full customer manifest that includes high-profile missions like deploying satellites for Amazon's Project Kuiper broadband constellation and launching NASA's Escapade twin orbiters to Mars. The launch, designated as NG-1, is part of Blue Origin's strategy to certify New Glenn for national security space launches, opening up potential contracts worth billions. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. You know, We're on a mission to reach 65,000 subscribers by next week. Join us on this journey, and let's see if we can make it happen together. The Blue Ring Pathfinder on this flight will test the operational capabilities of Blue Origin's in-space systems, providing critical data for future missions. This certification is crucial as it could lead to Blue Origin securing contracts for launches that involve national security payloads, thereby expanding its market significantly. The test flight's objectives are clear: safely reach orbit and, if possible, successfully land the booster. This dual focus is indicative of Blue Origin's broader vision to make space travel more accessible and sustainable through reusability. The lessons learned from this launch, regardless of its outcome, will be instrumental in refining future missions, ensuring that each flight contributes to the iterative improvement of their technology and procedures. In summary, the launch of New Glenn is not just a test of a new rocket, but a pivotal moment for Blue Origin. It represents the culmination of years of development, investment, and ambition to not only compete in the commercial space industry, but to push forward the boundaries of human space exploration. With significant interest from both commercial entities and governmental agencies, the success of New Glenn could herald a new era for Blue Origin, potentially reshaping the landscape of space travel in the years to come. As Blue Origin stands on the brink of this new chapter, the eyes of the space community are keenly watching, ready to see if this venture can indeed turn a chance into a reality. SpaceX marked another significant milestone in its ambitious Starlink project with the launch of the first batch of its internet satellites this year. On January 6th, from Florida's Space Coast, a Falcon 9 rocket ascended from Cape Canaveral's Space Force Station at 3:43 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, carrying 24 Starlink satellites into the sky. This mission not only furthered the company's goal of global internet coverage, but also showcased the reliability and reusability of SpaceX's launch technology. The Falcon 9's first stage, after propelling the spacecraft into the initial phase of their journey, executed a return to Earth. Approximately 8 minutes post-liftoff, it landed safely on the SpaceX drone ship named Just Read the Instructions, which was positioned in the Atlantic Ocean. This particular booster had already seen 17 launches and landings, with 10 dedicated to Starlink missions, underscoring the robustness of SpaceX's rocket recovery system. Notably, this booster had previously supported a crewed mission, Crew 5, to the International Space Station for NASA. After the first stage's separation, the Falcon 9's upper stage took over, tasked with delivering the satellites to their operational low Earth orbit. The deployment of these 24 satellites was scheduled to occur around 65 minutes following the launch, adding to the constellation that now numbers over 6,850 active Starlink spacecraft. This continuous expansion is tracked by Jonathan McDowell, an astrophysicist known for his satellite observations, highlighting the scale and pace of Starlink's growth. Starlink aims to provide high-speed internet across the globe, particularly in underserved and remote areas. Each launch, like today's, not only adds to the constellation, but also brings the world closer to universal broadband access. The project's scale makes it the largest satellite constellation ever deployed, reflecting SpaceX's commitment to revolutionizing how we connect to the internet from space. As these satellites begin their work in orbit, they continue to weave a network that promises to change the landscape of global communications. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.